So let's get going. Good morning, good afternoon, good day to those in the audience and those who are watching online. Thanks for joining us here. I'm Chris Kernker, otherwise known as Cranky. We'll introduce the geek here after me, Sai. Thanks for joining us. We've got a full packed day of fast-paced speaking. We've got some fast changeover of the speakers. We hope you'll stay with us. We've got some great items to raffle off. We've got some surveys to do so you can get your mobile phones out and get ready to participate in that. But I'm here to kind of get you settled in and get set up. I think we've all learned where the restrooms are, directly out the door and across. And we've got a couple of breaks scheduled here. So here's some important link stuff. It's all running now. If you have a question and you're shy about raising your hand, WebRTC Live's question, you can submit it online, and we have some folks taking a look at that. We've got two breaks scheduled here at 1:40 and 3:40, so there'll be plenty of time to get up and wander around and take a look at the gorgeous view outside. We've also got everyone hold on to your raffle ticket. We got lots of things to give away to make it worth your time, and the best, of course, is at the end of the day. So how did we get here? And we want to thank Google and the folks at TalkBox and Alessian who jumped up pretty quickly when Sahi and I were trying to pull this together. Very much appreciate their support, and of course they're here today also to answer any of your questions and to participate in this event. And really what we want to do is inspire you a little bit about what WebRTC is and what's possible with it, educate you, and I guess there's an element of entertainment here, some novel things we want to show, and I guess I'm part of the entertainment aspect because I'm old, and years ago I had walkie-talkies. I've been in communications for a long, long time. I love communications. Started with walkie-talkies calling my brother in the next room, much to his annoyance. And I've been doing communications ever since. And I'm actually a certified radio telephone operator by the FCC. I have one of these. In those days, you had to actually learn Morse code. So if something bad happens and we need Morse code, I'm your man, ready to help. You know, we live in a fishbowl here, and I want to kind of get your mind thinking as we go through the day, because it's very easy to forget how fast technology is changing, and what is new becomes old, and we get very focused on how things are and incremental changes. So I want to rewind us here just to set your mind about how we've communicated over the last 10 years. So think about where we are today, but let's go back just 10 years ago. Just 10 years ago, Verizon telling the world that they had two cities wired up for very high-speed mobile data rates at 153 kilobits per second. Bluetooth was telling the world that they were going to make the world cableless. Apple was telling the world with their iPod that they weren't going to support video. And the folks over at Blogger, I think they got that right. They said blogs are going to be big. Nokia, remember them? Not really. They were saying that two-thirds of all mobile phones would have cameras. Yeah, kind of close on that one. But think again. Now, that's just 10 years ago. Let's go back another 10 years. 10 years before that, in 1994, the Amazon.com domain was first bought. This was a cell phone I actually had. We had dial-up modems. MS-DOS was introducing version 6-point-something or another. And the World Wide Web was born. Back another 10 years, it gets a little scarier there. When you look at this mobile phone, Tetris was started, and the hottest networking item was FidoNet. So as you think about that, the question you have to ask yourself is, where are we going to be 10 years from today? Because I will guarantee you, as silly as these look, 10 years from today, we're going to look back on this date and go, God, you remember we walked around with these iPhones and looking at that? It was ridiculous. It was crazy. And I think to that part, we know things are going to change. We know it's going to change. And the folks who are in this room are part of that change in the way we communicate. Now, I was in, this is a photo I took, by the way. It's one of my best photos. I was in Sydney, Australia in May of 2011. And I read a small article about WebRTC. Didn't realize that was kind of around the birth moment of it. And I was very excited about WebRTC because it embodied a lot of the things I think I'd been looking for throughout my whole life, which was here was something that did voice, video, and data. And I was very excited about that because doing voice, video, and data has always been very hard. You had to, like, know a bunch of stuff. You had to be, like, speak these little code sort of stuff. And the realities are, WebRTC was about making that voice, video, and data communications accessible to basically a very modest level of programmer. And that was the excitement to me, but then it even got better. It got better because the notion of WebRTC is a peer-to-peer. It's about my computer connecting to another computer with a clear channel between the two. And I just envisioned all sorts of great things that could be done if I could simply reach across and create a pipe to someone else fairly effortlessly. And that's the real power that I think awaits us in the world of WebRTC, as you'll hear more today. You know, as I pointed out earlier in my life, I've been working in communications my whole life. And we have lots of communications. My phone is buzzing here, tweeting, God knows what is happening. But we almost have too much communications, because what we're trying to get at is the real heart of what communications is about. It's about collaboration. We hear it a lot in the world today. But, you know, you have communication, cooperation, coordination, and the ultimate, you know, wheat germ is collaboration. And more communications doesn't necessarily help us get to the underlying item that we're trying to get at, which is collaboration. And I think WebRTC is a major component that will help us get to this wheat germ kernel. Because today, the reports are now saying that in 2017, we're going to send 132 billion emails that year, approximately 120 per person, roughly one email every 4 minutes. I'm going to bet everyone in this room is pretty much at this level today. It's only going to get worse. And that isn't about improving communications. It's not about improving our collaboration. So there's a real opportunity to improve the communications from where we are today, so that when we look back in 2014 to 2004, we're going to go, oh, you remember when we were doing that? We were sending emails. Because everything comes back to, how do you become more efficient and more productive? That's what drives businesses. And so the folks who are in this room who are thinking of ideas about how we can improve the efficiency of our communication and how we can improve worker productivity, those are billion-dollar ideas. And I think WebRTC has a thread to that to help enable that. And I'm hoping today that you'll see some really neat ideas and some education on how you can get your own mind wrapped around some WebRTC applications to help in this mission. Now, we're going to get into some nuts and bolts. I've been sort of light and fluffy. We've got some people here, real propeller heads, are going to go deep propeller on you, because that's where, you know, you have to understand the bolts. But let's don't forget, as we're going along, what we're trying to build. We're trying to build an engine here, but more importantly, we're trying to build a vehicle in the communication space for collaboration and all these sorts of improvements to work productivity. So change is upon us. 10 more years from now, it's going to be totally different. And I think that you're at the very early stages of WebRTC. Thanks for joining us today. And welcome to WebRTC. Thanks.